13 years of the event. Now, we will not reach the 37,431 total this afternoon. On the other hand, if 14,964 attend the championship and third place in Double A tonight, some 61,176 would set a Class Double A attendance record, covering the 13-year existence of A and Double A competition. So we have A with the lowest possible attendance ever and Double A with the highest ever. A lot of interest for sure in the championship game in Class A, I'll tell you. All right, we salute the teams who have made it to state, meaning they are among the best, the top eight Class A and the top eight Double A. Now we go to St. Cloud Tech.
St. Cloud, 60 miles northwest of the Twin Cities, embracing the Mississippi River. It is a city of some 50,000 people possessing a unique school system. It's the home of St. Cloud Technical High School, founded in 1918. Rich in tradition, synonymous with excellence, committed to service, with pride in her achievements. With a current student body of over 1,700 students, Tech has graduated 22,000 alumni who possess a firm pride in the tiger, orange, and black. With its roots firmly planted in tradition, Tech continually rises to the challenge of the future. A unique blend of academic, artistic, and extracurricular activity.
Football tournament. We're getting ready for the Class A championship between Luverne and Barnum. But with me right now, John Friedman, the executive director of the Minnesota Special Olympics. And John, you've been with the program for just a short while, but I would imagine already you've learned plenty about it.
Well, Jeff, this is just a tremendous program. The Minnesota Special Olympics has over 7,200 athletes participating in the state right now with approximately 3,500 volunteers.
With us today, two very outstanding athletes, just a couple of the so many that represent Minnesota.
That's right. These two young men here, Dennis McCormick and David Baker, will be representing Minnesota in the international games in Baton Rouge, Louisiana at LSU in July.
Okay, pardon me while I step in front of here. First of all, Dennis, what events do you compete in?
I'm in the 220 and the relay, and the 220 and the relay, and running the both teams and swimming in the 20 and the relay too.
The 880 relay, right?
Yeah, the 80 relay, boys, track, field, and track, the relay, and the field, the relay, and the 20 and the relay.
It's a lot of fun, isn't it?
Oh, yes, it is.
Okay, let's talk to David. David, how about you? What event do you compete in?
Full hockey, passing ball.
You're in the 220 run, too, aren't you? I see you've got a gold medal there. That's a pretty special medal, isn't it?
Yeah.
Makes you proud to be wearing a medal like that, huh? All right, how about you, Dennis? You got the silver medal.
Yeah, this is the first time I went in the board hockey, and this year I was in the fourth game. Last year I went in the, and this is my first game, and I won a hockey tournament medal this summer. And I started learning basketball and this summer now, and learning ready and running this year, this summer now. The first game in the season now.
Okay, good luck to both of you in the international games. John, when are they going to be again?
The international games are July 12th to the 18th. There'll be over 50 countries competing and 4,000 athletes.
If anyone is interested out there, what should they do to contact the Special Olympics as a participant or a spectator?
Well, it's contact our office at 888-0883. We have 12 area coordinators throughout the state that are instructing and that are coordinating the activities, and then we in turn will contact the area coordinators, and they'll contact the interested parties.
This is the type of activity that's growing all the time, isn't it?
Oh yes, there's the amount of the potential for participation is unlimited, and this is what we're trying to accomplish: is get as many athletes involved in the various programs. There's 15 programs, individual and team sports, that Minnesota participates in, And we're trying to increase that participation, and we're confident that with the support that we're getting and the interest amongst the public and people like yourself, the news media that have been so good to us, that we're going to have an outstanding program in Minnesota before too long.
Okay, John, thanks a lot for being with us. Thanks, guys, and good luck again. Let's go back up to the booth.
Thank you very much, Jeff. It's good to see our friend John Friedman once again. John was the St. Paul Civic Center's very first manager when it was built. I believe the opening year was in 1974. He's been a great friend to all of us, for sure, since I've been here. John, now with the Special Olympics, and a great job for a very great individual. He started an outstanding tradition here at the Civic Center, being carried on beautifully by Marlene Anderson and her staff. The 1983 Minnesota State High School Boys Basketball Tournament will continue after station identification.
For the State High School Boys Basketball Tournament.
We are back live at the St. Paul Civic Center, just about ready to get underway with a Class A championship. Barnum taking on Luverne. With me, a couple of Barnum cheerleaders, I guess you would call them. I don't know what to call them. This guy's got a basketball on his head. This guy's got an airplane on him. I don't know what to call. What's your name?
I'm Stan Mraz.
Stan, where did you get the idea with the basketball?
I don't know. I kind of thought about it on my own, and I thought you know, I'd really help get the fans going and get the support going. So you can see that Barnum's got the number one crowd here. Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. Hi, everybody in the falls.
Let me ask you this. How do you keep that thing on your head? Why don't you take it off and let's see what it looks like.
I got stocking caps underneath.
And it is a real basketball.
It's a real basketball, yep.
Now, tell me the truth. Is everybody from Barnum down here for this game? I mean, the whole town?
Well, they say Barnum's only 400, but you look up in the stands, and there's a lot of people out there. I don't know. There's a lot of towns around the area that's supporting them, you know. It's just great, though. It's just high school basketball now. It's just great, you know. It's the tournaments. There's nothing like high school basketball at state tournaments.
Let me ask you this. Do you think Barnum was going to get here all along?
Well, I knew they had a heck of a team, but, God, I don't know if they'd come this far. It's just great, though. I don't know.
All right, now with me over here is the last of the Red Barons. What is your name?
My name is Keith Johnson.
Keith, where did you get this crazy idea?
Well, we just happened to see a couple garbage cans sitting there, and we put them up to each against me, and it looked like a bomber. And, you know, when you got a bomber, it's something hard to put together, but I guess this is about the best costume they've come up with so far.
Okay, now I want to show you this. These guys have been changing these numbers after every game. They've got this right here at 25-0. So they are keeping things up to date. Now this thing is made out of a garbage can there and a garbage can in the back, cardboard for the tails, and believe it or not, the propeller works. Why don't you show them? Look at that, isn't that great? All right, thanks a lot, guys. Let's go back upstairs.
Randy?
Yeah.
You know something? Those guys, they can walk in the streets of St. Paul or Minneapolis and people would turn their heads. They couldn't believe it. But if they wore those same outfits in New York or Los Angeles, not one person would notice.
They'd get away with it. No problem.
This is the 1983 Minnesota State High School Boys Basketball Tournament.
Before the flowers start blooming, beautify your home with True Test paints during spring spruce up at True Value Hardware Stores. You'll add elegance to rooms with velvety satin.
Now, to the home of the Luverne Cardinal, Minnesota State High School Boys Basketball Tournament. Their one game, well, the whole season hinges on it. The Barnum Bombers, the Luverne Cardinals battling for the A championship. State of Minnesota. Barnum 25-0, Luverne 19-6. Now let's go down to Julie Pearl.
Championship game. We remind you, no smoking in any part of the arena. Also, your official tournament programs and t-shirts are on sale in the lobby. Now, we will introduce the entire squad except the starters of the two teams. The starters will be introduced later alternately. Starting for Luverne. Luverne is the visitor on your scoreboard. Number 11, Greg Carroll.
Who's not here?
Number 13, Steve Waiter. Number 15, Joel Elbers. Number All right, we'll start over with number 13, number 12, Steve Waiter. Number 20, Carrie Aaron. 22, John Nikolai. 24, Darwin Siebenhaller. Number 30, Brad Arendt. 34, Tom Madison. 40, Todd Flattaquall. Number 42, Alan Fixie. 44, Scott Smite. 54, Joel Pickett. Non-starting squad for Barnum. Number 11, Lauren Peterson. 13, Doug Juntinen. 53, Jody Young. 21, Dwayne Palmer. 25, Jack Peterson. 41, Mark Magnuson. 25, Steve Spoolman. 51, Leif Egan. 53, Pete Charbonneau.
It just gets your concentration on shot.
All right, now we go. Now these starting lineups. Rodney Serra, we missed. Sorry about that. 55. Now we got starters to be introduced, alternately starting for Luverne at forward, number 32, Mike Hoyland. For Barnum, number 31, Robbie Peterson. At forward, 52, Tim Vink. Forward, 33, Darren Juntinen. Center, number 50, Gordy Hansen. Center, 43, Todd Lind. Guard, Greg Carroll, number 10. Guard, 23, Mark Solheim. Guard, 14, Joel Elbers. And guard, number 35, Jim Myrie. All right, ladies and gentlemen, may we have your attention while the Barnum High School Band, directed by Craig Bonneman, leads us in the national anthem.
Jim Dutcher, what do you think about this game, Luverne and Barnum?
Well, I think there's a little more pressure on Barnum. They're the team that's 25-0. They've played from ahead most of the year. Laverne's coming off a very impressive performance yesterday. One of the things about these two teams, Tom, 7 of the 10 starters are juniors. So basketball fans should get used to seeing these two teams. We may see them again next year.
Here we go, the Class A Championship, State of Minnesota. Gordy Hansen, he'll jump for Laverne. He had 30 points yesterday. Todd Lind, go up for Barnum, and the tip is controlled by the Laverne Cardinals. 358 students, coached by Lauren Carroll, 22nd year, comes into this game with 344 wins.
Barnum started out in a 1-3-1 zone. Rob Peterson is the baseline man, and Eddie almost had the interception.
Laverne inbounding beneath their own basket out on top. Carroll, little 10-footer, and he pops it in. First points of the game. Greg Carroll. He averages 10 a game. He had 4 in the first quarterfinal game and 8 in the semifinal, and starts off on a good note here for his Laverne Cardinals. Driving inside, Myrie. Rebound pulled out of there by Laverne, and they have it. They lead by 2. Luke just opened up play.
Laverne playing that tough man-to-man defense. They forced the miss first possession.
Knocked out of bounds. Barnum, coached by Russ Radetzky, 11th year. He has 168 wins coming into this game.
I've got a question for Coach Jim Dutcher. Jim, Barnum, obviously the smaller of those two teams. What do you do? Do you let Hansen get his points and worry about everybody else, or
no,
do you try and double up on him?
He's got started right there. They're going to sag in, try to keep the ball away from Hansen and make them make some outside shots.
Barnum with a basketball out on top. Trying to work it inside. Good body control on that shot by Todd Lind, and he was fouled.
Hansen scores a one end, and Lind comes right back and says, hey, I can do that too. This is the inside pass. He fakes the baseline drive. Dips in under Hansen, gets fouled on the arm.
Greg Carroll got the foul. His first here. We've just opened up play. Laverne leading by a score of 4-2. Barnum at the free throw line, working on a three-point play. That is Todd Lind. No good. Hansen with a rebound for Laverne. Laverne, they average 58 a game. Usually give up 51. Barnum, they average 75 a game. Give up 54. Unbeaten, traveling. The Barnum Bombers, front court. Deliberate offense. Watch how that defense will shift at the movement of the ball. The location of the ball dictates where the defensive player is supposed to be and the unit as a whole. Off somebody's foot, they're racing into the back court, and there's going to be a foul called on Barnum. Jim Myrie.
He got there a step late. It was a foot race for the ball. The race was won by Laverne. Barnum picked up the foul. Both teams are changing their defenses some. Barnum showing a 1-3-1 zone right now.
That's Elbers with a basketball, 6'1 junior. Now he and Carroll playing catch. Carroll with an 18-footer. Rebound pulled out of there by the Barnum Bombers. Lind. Lind's having an excellent first quarter. That's Lind from the line. Got it.
He showed us two moves. He showed us a move to the basket. Now he showed us the jump shot. Very versatile offensive player.
They're tied up at 4, 5:25 remaining first quarter. Championship of the state in Class A. Pass deflected. Looks like a 2-on-2, maybe 3-on-2. And here's a foul is going to be called on Greg Carroll of Laverne.
Mark Solheim got in too close to Lind. He took away his move to the basket. You see the fast break, and you see Solheim is in too tight, took away the passing lane. He did get fouled on the drive.
Carroll's second foul, I might add. Barnum, shot out of the corner was no good. That was Judson who took a whack at it out of the corner, and now coming into the front court.
You're going to see Luverne come down and try to get the ball to Hanson. Barnum knows that, and they've really got a group around him.
Back rim, cutting in to get the rebound, Myrie. Boy, they racehorse it into the front court, driving, great body control, and a bucket by Mark Solheim.
That was the picture fast break, just like you put it on the board. Wingman stayed wide, got a right on time, great pass.
Look at that feed. All alone, Tim Vink.
Right now we're seeing championship caliber basketball.
6-6 the score. 4:25 remaining first quarter. Turnaround jump shot, a beauty by Lind. He's having a great first quarter. He had 25 points in the quarterfinal game and 15 points in the semifinals yesterday. Steal, nope, stepped on the sideline.
Barnum came with the trapping defense. Lind went for the steal, made a valiant effort to save it inbounds, but his foot was on the sideline.
Timeout on the floor with the score. Barnum 8, Luverne 6. Pauls and Jim Plownick from Apple Valley, a tribute to them being among the best, being tabbed to do a state championship game. Luverne with the ball. Shot up, and it's good by Hoyland. Tied up again, 8-8. Barnum with the ball. Working it very quickly against that defense. That's Lind. He has been everywhere in this first quarter.
Great movement of the ball by Barnum. They swung the ball from the strong side to weak side, picked up Lind, and they're doing a great job. You'll see it here, the cross-court pass to Lind. Gives the ball fake, baseline drive, trying to stay out of the way. The Luverne player did get him on the shoulder.
First foul on Joel Elbers on that. Free throw is good by Todd Lind. He now has 7 points in this first quarter, and Barnum leads 9-8. 3:44 remaining.
He's a very confident junior.
Perfect.
One, two, one, one press, full court.
Oh boy, they had an open man there.
Threw over the top of the press. Now they're settling back into their 1-3-1 zone.
Cutting inside Hanson, he's their guy, and he got it. Hanson with 30 points in the semifinals. And they defeated Clara City 59-43. Shot up good, a beauty by Robbie Peterson.
Backed his way into the lane, put up the left-handed jump shot.
Peterson averages 20 a game. In the quarterfinals, he had 16. In the semifinals yesterday, he had 14.
Tom, these teams haven't heard about championship jitters. They're
That's
both
right.
out there just bombing away, making them.
We're not getting that sort of feeling that they're just testing each other. They're just going after each other.
They're going after each other. Rob Peterson.
Shot. Peterson rolls out of there, and the follow-up is a dandy by guess who? Todd Lind. Barnum with a 4-point lead. 2.5 minutes left to go, first quarter. Tom Ryder along with Coach Jim Dutcher up top here at the Civic Center. Randy Shaver, Jeff Passel down on the floor at midcourt.
Greg Carroll's trying to get him settled into a patient offensive attack here. He's the point guard. He runs the attack.
Shot coming up a little bit flat by Elbers and racehorsed into the front court by Barnum. Quick shot up and good. Boy, I tell you, heavy traffic, but Solheim got it in.
Rob Peterson gave him a good-looking pass. He pivoted, threw it in, and it was a set shot, really. He didn't leave the floor, but he got rid of it quickly.
Solheim doesn't score much. He averages about 3 a game, but when you get offensive help from players who do not score a lot, that's just a blessing you think.
It really gives you a boost.
Out of the corner. Shot was a little bit long. The follow-up shot, no good by Elbers. Barnum gets it back. That's Myrie.
Great save by Myrie.
Tom and Jim, I want to remind everybody, we talked about it yesterday. If the Barnum Bombers can manage to win this Class A championship, they will be the smallest community ever to do that. Barnum has a population of 382. The smallest ever is Edgerton, 1960, with a population of 1,114. So that'd be quite an accomplishment for Barnum. And as I look over to my right here, I think the whole town is sitting in the stands.
At least, looks like the whole county.
There's a steal by Luverne.
Luverne has got to show some patience at the offensive end. Move the ball around. Find Gordy Hansen on the inside. He hasn't touched the ball recently. They've got right in there. They've got to get it inside.
Inside Hansen and couldn't get it. Rebound, Barnum.
Had his shot, didn't make it.
Well, that looked like a pass going into the end zone. What an athletic play there to save that ball from going out of bounds. Robbie Peterson out on top with it. That was saved beautifully by Darren Gentleman.
Looks like they're going to hold for the last shot of the quarter with 29 seconds to go.
Barnum with a six-point lead.
Well-drilled basketball team.
It's not hard to figure out why they're 25-0.
No, it sure isn't.
Down the lane, passing off to Lim. Good defensive play by Luverne. Hansen was in on one of the blockers, and they had another player. Now that's Hansen.
Great
running
pass.
Quickly. He was fouled by number 31, Robbie Peterson.
Hansen pulled up, let the traffic go by, and then was fouled when he did put it up. You can see the pass here. Hansen pump fakes, waits for Lim to go on by him, and then draws the foul. Rob Peterson fouled him.
Hansen at the line. He has 4 points. 4 seconds left, first quarter. He now has five. 16-11, Barnum. This is Luverne's ninth trip to the state tournament. The first one in 1913. They won it in 1964. Sharp. 3 seconds. Well, they better hurry up. Last ditch effort there. And that's the end of the first quarter, and a good one it's been with a score. Barnum 16, Luverne 11.
Court side here at the Civic Center, 16-11, Barnum on top. Barnum making their first state tournament appearance. Luverne has been here 8 times previously, 1913, 1935, 36, 38, 64, they were champions, 65, 67, 71, and 1983.
Here's the tip-off play. No basket. Traveling is going to be called on Darren Juntinen.
It was a good call. He tried to get his feet set to go up for the layup. Didn't move both feet just before he shot the ball.
We've just opened up the second quarter. Lead pass into the front court, high into the air to protect it was Vink. He's a big guy, 6'4". That's Greg Curl on top. Elbers in the corner. Getting his screen, firing it up. Carroll. Carroll follows the ball, gets his rebound.
They're trying to get the ball into Hansen, but he's got three players surrounding him. He gets the rebound up and scores.
Boy, he is big. I'll tell you, that first shot was by Hoyle and Jim, but Hansen knows how to use that size. A junior averages 15 a game. He's their top rebounder and scorer.
Got another battle of the centers. They're just not quite as big as Vandenatti and Coco.
That was a dandy last night in Double A.
Sure was.
We had just under 17,000 people here, standing room only. Shot rolls around.
Yeah.
Look at that. Took a while, but finally went down. That was Myrie's first 2 points of the game. Barnum leads 18-13.
Threw it away against the press.
Too high and out of bounds.
Barnum has faith in their pressing defense. They know that if they keep it on long enough, they're going to get some turnovers, and that's what happened in the semifinal game.
Behind the back dribble there by Myrie. That's confidence playing for the state championship. You're whipping that ball behind your back. in close. That was Lynn. Did they say it hit the uprights?
Yeah, it was deflected and hit the support under the basket.
Once it hits any of those beams, automatically it's a dead ball. Very quickly in the front court. A nice bounce pass would have done there. Vink got his hands on it, and it goes out of bounds. It was knocked out of there by Barnum. Inbounding is... That was Hoyland. And that shot up and good by Carroll.
That was a set play for Carroll. They screened the weak side of the zone. He broke behind on the out-of-bounds play and made the jump shot.
Luverne coming back. They trail by three. Barnum with the ball. They almost lost it there. Here is a foul going to be called on Luverne. Holding up his hand is number 32, another big guy, Mike Hoyland.
He got the ball and realized that he was behind the backboard, so he did the only thing he could. He took it to the basket and drew the foul. Here's the replay. You can see he was behind the backboard, and he took it up. He got fouled.
Shot out of the deep corner, rolls out of there. That was Jumpin'. No basket, whistled before the shot. Have a jump ball. Myrie will jump for Barnum. I believe that's Hoyland for Luverne.
No, it was Hanson.
He was standing exactly sideways. Oh, boy, driving was Elbers. Follow-up is no good. There's a whistle. I don't think that's going to count, but let's wait and see. Official goes over.
The impressive thing about this is Hanson was the player that jumped. You can see the shot missed, but there's Hanson on the follow-up. And he was the player that was involved in the jump ball, so he really hustled down to the other end.
That was Myrie's second foul. He checks out of the lineup. Palmer checks into the Barnum lineup. Here we have number 24 checking in, Darwin Siebenhaler for the Luverne Cardinals.
Hanson's got a chance to cut it to two here.
Hanson, their big guy in more ways than one. He's a great rebounder and their top scorer. And timeout on the floor with the score of Barnum 18, Luverne 16.
Paul Civic Center, Jeff Passel along with Randy Shaver here at courtside. And the third and final day of the Boys State High School basketball tournament. It all got going early this morning. In Class A, the consolation championship, Brooklyn Center 43, Lake City 41. So Brooklyn Center claims the consolation championship in Class A. Then in Class AA, Edina defeated Minneapolis North 49-45. Edina, the consolation champion in AA. And our third place game earlier this afternoon, we had Staples defeating Clara City 55-42. Staples, the third place champion. And right here, we have Barnum leading 20-16 over Luverne.
That was Robbie Peterson who went all the way for Barnum. And they, as Jeff told you, have a four-point lead. 5:15 remaining in the first half. Luverne took an early lead. Barnum came back. Now they have the lead. Ball is knocked out of bounds by Barnum, getting his hands on it, Darren Gentleman.
Here's the set play again. Last time they screened for Carroll on the weak side, and he made the jump shot. This time he stayed out top. They're just going to work against the set defense now.
I always enjoy the inbound plays, all the maneuvering going on. There's a good-looking shot. Greg Carroll, 5'9", junior. Always room for the little man who can move
sure
it and shoot.
Is. He's playing the baseline now, Carroll, on a 1-3-1 zone, which is going to see him having to go corner-to-corner coverage and sag in on Lind. So you'll see Carroll playing Lind a little on the inside when the ball goes.
High pass nabbed in there by Barnum. Boy, some fine athletes down on the floor for both ball clubs. Somehow you felt this was going to be a goodie. That's Lind. The shot was deflected, and now Luverne racing into the front court. Carroll, long pass, and oh, look out, Hanson into the band section for Barnum. He's okay.
And Carroll Barnum gave him a lead pass, Tom. He just couldn't catch up to it. He tried to save it inbounds, and Hanson was on a dead all-out sprint, but he just couldn't catch up to the ball.
Hello to our network stations, KDLH in Duluth, Minnesota, KAAL in Austin, KCMT in Alexandria, and KTTC in Rochester. Flagship station, of course, WTCN Channel 11, Minneapolis-St. Paul. Our 25th year of bringing you the tournament and 30 years of televised state tournament action, dating back to 1954. Barnum, quick feed down under. Couple of good-looking hits. What a shot by Jump Peterson. Ball. Will it go?
There was a good defensive play. He went to the floor after he'd come down on top of the ball. We'll see a replay of this. You get the inside pass to Rob Peterson. Here he gets the rebound, fakes it. You see he's right on top of the ball. And he went to the floor after the jump. It was a good call by the official. Although the fans don't necessarily agree with it, it was a good call.
It is unbelievable. Peterson was able to get the ball up and into the basket. He jumped with Vink. And, well,
he said, take that. You blocked the last one, but not this one.
This one I'll take. That's Peterson.
Another jump ball with Peterson.
These teams, as you mentioned earlier, Jim, I mean, just flat out going at it.
They are. They know this is the culmination of 4.5 months of work, and they want that trophy.
Timeout on the floor with a score of Barnum 22, Luverne 18. Call getting a haircut for the occasion. The old-fashioned mohawk there, Jim.
I hope he didn't pay to have that done. A younger sister must have done that.
3:31 remaining in the first half. Vink jumping for Luverne against number 31, Robbie Peterson for Barnum. Luverne has it. 22-18, Barnum. Luverne working it out on top deliberately.
They're looking strong inside for Hanson. They got to get Vink involved in the game a little bit. He's the other big man.
Oh, that's a long shot. 20-footer by Carroll is good. Tightening up the game. We have a two-point game. 3 minutes left, first half.
Luverne playing a tough 1-3-1 zone right now with Carroll running the baseline. Greg's not very big there, but he is active. You'll see he'll come to the opposite side as the ball is reversed. He just follows the ball. Now he'll come to this corner.
There was a good fake, and that set that old play up by Darren Jensen, and he used the fake of the pass, and the defense moved, and he had a wide-open shot.
Carroll got there just a step late.
Four-point lead, Barnum. 2:22 remaining first half. The Barnum crowd yelling defense. Carroll again, that time short. Rebound down under, and the follow-up is good by Tim Vink. He has 4 points, and we have a two-point game, Barnum by two. Barnum up near Duluth, about 30 miles to the south. Luverne in the southwest corner of Minnesota. Luverne, even though they've lost six games, they have won 9 straight. So they're on a roll.
They're attacking the 1-3-1 zone down on the baseline where you should get it inside here. He's been out of the game for a while. They got it to Lind, but he didn't score.
Lind has been slowed down a little bit. He had 10 points in the first quarter, has yet to score here in the second.
Luverne has made some very good defensive adjustments. They're not letting him have that inside pass.
Carroll, in and out. He has a depth touch from out there. Very nice shot. He kind of slipped before he got that one off, and we have a whistle, and a foul will be called. It is on Barnum.
Carroll, a little look of disgust on his face. You can see he makes a good move. Pump fakes. There's nobody there to fake. The ball comes up a little short. It's batted around. Goes out of bounds. But Carroll has to keep taking those shots against the zone. They're there, and he has to keep taking them. Here's the out-of-bounds play now on the slap of the ball.
Palmer in for Myrie for Barnum.
Driving. Great pass.
Oh, very nice. Robbie Peterson cashed in, but it was the pass that made that.
It was a great feed.
we're going to have a turnover. They'll go the other way. Got some hockey scores here. Final score, the North Stars beat Detroit 7-5. They came from behind. And Providence defeated the Gophers for third place in the NCAA tournament at North Dakota 4-3. So I'm sure that Brad Buteau is going to be hard to live with when he gets back, Jim.
Well, you don't like to end the season with two losses, but in total, Brad had a great season. Right now, it doesn't seem like a great season because they lost the two tournament games, but they were ranked number one most of the year.
42 seconds remaining in the half, Barnum. They lead by four. They're not waiting for the last shot. They're just pumping it up. Basket counts.
Nice follow-up basket by Robbie Peterson. He's been all over the place the first half. He's not very big. He's only a 6'3" player, but he plays bigger than that. So active.
Really is very, very strong performer for the Barnum Bombers.
He started as a freshman, Tom, so although he's a junior, he's been a three-year starter.
Smythe got the foul. He averages 20 a game, so he's no stranger to putting the ball through the hoop.
He looked to the bench to see if they want to go for last shot or not. I believe that's what they're playing. It's 23 seconds to go.
Barnum leading by six. Luverne choosing to go for the final shot. We're down to 15 seconds. And a steal. They did not want that. Coming out of the pack, Dwayne Palmer. Shovels it in the corner. Back rim shot no good by Juntinen. And the follow-up is good by Juntinen. I'll tell you, that's moving after it, and that's the end of the first half with a score. Barnum 30 and Luverne 22.
What sort of things just weren't happening your way?
Well, we did some very poor things at the end of the second quarter. It might be a little tough to get back in this game. They're quick, this is a factor. They're quite a bit quicker than we are. And we're not getting the ball on the inside very easily either. So we got a lot of work to do.
I see your son is keeping you in the ball game with some of those shots outside.
Well, he's got to hit a few of those, but we got to get the ball down inside a little bit of it too.
Okay.
Got to get it there.
Good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
Okay, let's go back upstairs.
You know, part of the state tournament is the great halftime and between game entertainment. We want you to sit back now and watch a very, very special treat. The drill team from Cold Spring, Ricori. You are in for a treat.
Pre-game ceremonies.
All right, we are at halftime here of the Class A Championship game, and we're getting ready for some outstanding halftime entertainment. This is Bob Harris, the director of the group from Cold Spring Ricori. Bob, tell us about the group.
Well, it's during the winter months, we are strictly an entertainment guard. During the summer months, the color guard is part of our marching band, which is travels all over the country.
How many students are involved here?
We have 61.
And how much practice has gone into your event right here today?
Well, we have our tryouts in September. We start our season about in October, and it amounts to about 5 hours individual work for each member. We have one full rehearsal a week, and then they break down into sections for their practices during the week.
How many different routines do you do?
We work on one a year.
I was watching before you were practicing here, and it's very precise. I was going to say, how could you do more than one a year with all the precise movements that are going on here?
Yeah, we work on a difficulty, you know, factor and try to perfect as well as we can what we do.
So. How many competitions have you been involved in?
Well, we're not a competitive guard anymore. We used to be. We used to be a member of the Northwest Color Guard Circuit, North Star Color Guard Circuit, and the Midwest Color Guard. But we thought we would rather build a show for entertainment rather than building it for judges. So that's what we've tried to do.
Well, we're going to step off to the side, and I think you folks will agree this is an outstanding group, a very entertaining group, and I think you'll be amazed at some of the things you're seeing. Let's step aside.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I don't know about you, but as a former ground pounder with the 1st Infantry Division, that sent chills up and down my spine. What a performance from the Cold Spring Ricori drill team. This is the 1983 Minnesota State High School Boys Basketball Tour. We're about ready to start the second half. Robbie Peterson has 10 for Barnum. Lynn has 10 all in the first quarter. They're leading the way for Luverne. We have Carroll with 8, and we have Hanson with 8. And as the Luverne coach said, they're going to have to start getting that ball to their big men, Jim.
Well, it was a good first half for Barnum. They only had 2 turnovers in the entire half, shot 54% from the floor, got the ball to their 2 big scorers, Lind and Peterson. Just an outstanding half for Barnum.
The 1983 Minnesota State High School Boys Basketball Tournament will continue after station identification.
We return you to the St. Paul Civic Center and the Minnesota State High School Boys Basketball Tournament.
Welcome back to the St. Paul Civic Center. Randy Shaver along with Barnum head coach Rush Medeski. Rush, you had a nice charge there at the end of the second quarter to put yourself back up, put your team up by 8 points.
Well, Robbie Peterson was doing some good penetration there and drew the 3-point play, and we've been making a few turnovers and giving them taking them out of their offense and have to work inside to get it in Hanson. I think defensively we're doing a good job trying to keep Hanson from scoring, so I'm pretty pleased right now where we're at right now. I just hope that our press and our pressure here can keep them out of their game, and we can continually to penetrate and play our type of game and get the shooting like we have.
All right, coach, good luck in the
second
half.
Thank you very much.
Okay, Tom, let's go back up to you.
This is the 1983 Minnesota State High School Boys Basketball Tournament. A little while ago, apparently this is going to be the lowest Class A attendance since they went to A and AA in the 13-year existence of this tournament, but I think that definitely is very much due to we have a lot of small towns here.
That's right. Barnum and Luverne are well supported by their communities. They're just not large population areas. That's why they're Class A schools. But the encouraging crowd that we had last night and the enthusiasm of the Class A crowds that has been here has more than made up for the lack of attendance in the Class A.
Well, as a matter of fact, AA could set a AA attendance record during the 13-year existence of A and AA competition. Last night we had just under 17,000. That's the first time we've had standing room here at the St. Paul Civic Center. And all we need to break a record tonight is 14,964. And I kind of think we're going to get it.
I think we are. And in Class A, there's a lot of competition on Saturday afternoons. But it's a great final here. And Laverne's going to try to cut into that 8-point deficit as quickly as they can.
Here's the tip, and the second half is underway. The Class A Championship, State of Minnesota, on the line. Greg Carroll for Luverne, the coach's son. Fine player. Out on top, Elbrus. Barnum leading 30-22 as we open play. Tom Ryder along with University of Minnesota coach Jim Dutcher. Shot wide to the right, Elbrus. Randy Shaver, Jeff Passholder courtside. Shovel shot, dandy by Robbie Peterson.
Scoop shot by Peterson. He had a fine first half, scored 10 points. He was 5-for-7 for the first half, so he's 6-for-8 right now.
Good-looking steal there, cutting in. And grabbing it out of there was Solheim with the quick hands. And Barnum, they've come out storming. They lead by 10, their biggest lead.
Staying in their same zone defense as Luverne, trying to collapse in on Lynn, but they fouled him on that trip.
Tom and Jim, I've got welcome home celebration information here. Everybody get your pen and paper ready, all sorts of them. Wilmer, welcome home celebration for the Wilmer Cardinals will be held at 2 p.m. on Sunday afternoon at the Wilmer
High
School
gym. You see the ball going inside, he got fouled.
Okay, Brooklyn Center, their welcome home celebration will be Sunday at 2 p.m. at the Brooklyn Center High School Gymnasium. For Lake City, 1:30 p.m. at Lake City High School on Sunday. The Edina Hornets will be held at 8:30 a.m. on Monday morning at Edina High School Gymnasium. Minneapolis North, 12:30, with a parade beginning at Theater Worth Park and then to the high school gym for a program at 1 p.m. on Sunday. Clara City will be held at the high school gym on Sunday beginning at 1 p.m. A car caravan will form at Bundy Corner at 12:45 p.m. Staples A welcome home reception for the Staples Cardinals tonight at 9:30 p.m. in the Staples High School Gymnasium. And then for Barnum, welcome home celebration for the Barnum basketball team will be held tomorrow, 2:30 p.m. A caravan will meet in Sturgeon Lake on Old Highway 61 at 2 p.m. tomorrow. And for Luverne, the welcome home celebration will be held Sunday afternoon at 3:30 p.m. at the Luverne High School.
Almost sounded like a list of school closings there.
And for my wife, I'll be home soon.
Hasn't seen you, Jim, for the last three or four days you've been here at the Civic Center.
We've been on a recruiting trail in
right
here. Here's the replay on it. Good aggressive play, gets it inside, turns, looks for the jump shot, goes up square. This comes off the rim and the foul by Vink over the shoulder.
Second foul on Vink, 34-22. Barnum leading 6:28 remaining third quarter. Barnum with the ball. 17-footer coming up sharp. Peterson on that shot. They'll go the other way.
He tried to save it. The referee was in his way a little bit. He couldn't quite get at the ball. It's important right now that Luverne score this trip down the court. The momentum is definitely on the side of Barnum. They're aggressive on defense. They're forcing the action. Luverne has to come down, get settled into their offense, and get a basket here out of Hanson.
Corner. Luverne moving it around now. Out on top, Carroll. Their playmaker. That shot of Boomer swishing through. That's Hoyland. He has 4 points from the deepest part of the corner. He hit on that one.
Now toughen up the defensive end. They're still in the 1-3-1 zone. Rob Peterson keeps penetrating that zone defense.
Something's wrong if he can dribble that deeply into it.
There he goes. He splits the seams.
That shot was no good. An attempt up there by Peterson, and Luverne has it. We're at 5:26 remaining third quarter. Barnum leading Luverne 34-24. High pass.
A great interception by Rob Peterson. He could anticipate the cross-court pass coming. He got there in the passing lane and saved it inbounds.
What an athletic play. Grabbed it with his right hand, went sailing out of bounds, flipped it underhanded. Got it back in. Barnum with the ball and a 10-point lead.
Another great play by Carroll at the other end.
Luverne showing they're not out of it as they come into the front court. They're trying to get back into it. They're down by 10. Carroll, 5'9 junior. Hoyland and Vink are the only seniors in the starting lineup for Luverne.
Nice follow by Hanson.
Hanson, boy, they need that.
Yeah, he missed the initial shot, the turnaround jump shot, but he got it back and now has a chance to complete the three-point play. Here he gets it inside, turns off the back of the rim, but he follows it up quickly, goes up. Rob Peterson's there to foul him. He's got a chance now to cut this lead.
Solheim out of the Barnum lineup and coming in, I believe that's Dwayne Palmer. It is. Hanson short. Juntinen stepped in to get the rebound. Nice looking pass up for the shot. No good. Palmer and a foul.
He passed it off the dribble, which is a very tough thing to do. We don't recommend it very often because you don't have good control. And a lot of times when you pass it off the dribble, the ball will have some topspin. You can see he passed it right off the dribble, and it kind of jumps as it hits the floor. But he did get pushed and will have the two-shot foul.
Third foul on Greg Carroll for Luverne. Dwayne Palmer is a 6-foot junior at the line. Got it. 35-26 Barnum.
Got a chance to put it back up to 10 here.
Palmer is their sixth man. He averages 5 points a game. Rebound Peterson. He tried to get it. He was on his knees and he tried to shoot it.
That's one of those set shots.
Shot. Beauty by Carroll. He's not bothered by his three fouls. He went all the way. 35-28 Barnum. 4:19 remaining, third quarter. That's Palmer. Yes, he got it.
The problem that Laverne's having in her zone is Rob Peterson is splitting the top seam. Everyone has to collapse on the ball and get the opening.
Hanson And he got it in. Hansen with 12.
Right now, they've got to stop Rob Peterson from penetrating from the top. Here he comes into the middle of the zone, drops it off.
Oh, Lim.
Ball on Hansen.
Down went Todd Lim.
What happens when you allow penetration? You can see the penetration. You use up your defensive players. They have to come and try to stop. You can see Hansen stepped up. That leaves Lynn alone underneath. And if you can stop that initial drive, then you can keep your big men in position.
Todd Lynn, who had 10 points in the first quarter and not 1 point all the way up to this time. He had a great first quarter, but from there on, he's been shut out. And that does not end the drought. Lind had a great quarterfinal game with 25 points. He had 15 in the semifinals. Averages 19 a game. He's a junior. And that ends the drought. Timeout on the floor with a score. Barnum 38, Luverne 30.
They've come out to open the second half, played solid basketball, but they have the same 8-point deficit that they had at halftime. And he's just hoping that they can score two or three in a row.
3:41 remaining, third quarter. Barnum's lead cut to 8 points. Luverne sneaking back into it. The Cardinals, this has been the year of the Cardinals.
Right.
The Wilmer Cardinals, the Coon Rapids Cardinals, the Staples Cardinals, Luverne Cardinals. Hansen, good defensive player by Barnum, and a follow-up shot is good. I believe that was Elbers.
Everybody kind of stopped. They were anticipating a whistle. There was no whistle. Elbers stuck with the play and scored.
His first 2 points. Coming at a good time for them. We're down to 3 minutes, third quarter.
It's a 6-point ball game right now.
Good looking shot by Palmer.
That was Rob Peterson, the lefty. I got up at the free throw line, made the turnaround jump shot.
Palmer is 21. Robbie Peterson is 31. And Robbie is left-handed.
Little indecision on Hansen's part. He didn't want to charge, so he pulled up, tried to pass it across, and it got deflected out of bounds. Set play for Carroll. He scored off it once.
He loves that position.
And no.
Good touch there.
You're right.
Hung up there and then fell off. On the drive. That's Palmer. No good. Luverne breaking it out, but they don't have a play. They slow it down. Barnum. 2:15 remaining, third quarter.
They've got Fink up at a high post now, trying to set some screens for Carroll to come off for the jump shot.
Missed on the long 18-footer, and that time, well, there's a coach's nightmare there. Carroll ran into and picked up his fourth foul.
Well, 5'9", he got there and stuff. You can see Rob Peterson with the left-handed lead pass. Carroll's going for the interception, gets there just behind the ball and commits the foul.
I think they're going to put in Darwin Siebenhaler, who's a 5'9 senior. Carroll will go to the bench with four fouls, and that's going to hurt him.
They can't keep him out too long. He's too key to their attack. He's the coach's son. He's running the show for them, and they'll give him a few minutes here. Hopefully they can get out of the third quarter and still only be eight down so they can have him fresh for the fourth quarter.
Don't forget, more great basketball coming up tonight. We'll be on the air at 7 o'clock with the Class AA third place game, Chisago Lakes against Wilmer, and then the dream game, number one ranked Coon Rapids, 24-0, against number two ranked Woodbury, 23-0.
Oh, it's going to be really an interesting basketball game. The physical strength of Coon Rapids, the play of Copa and Kevin Trainer against the perimeter shooting of a Billy Scheffler and a Trost and some of the other Woodbury Royals.
Barnum, despite the fact they were undefeated coming in here, they were sort of an unknown quantity, but I think that they certainly have proved to a lot of people that they are for real.
everybody looks at them. They're a junior ball club, basically, and they question whether they have the tournament experience. And their first trip to the tournament, they're going to make the best of it.
Myrie at the line. No good. Luverne clearing it out. Hoyland. Siebenhaler with it now. He's the guy who just checked in. Hoyland takes the long shot. And the follow-up rolls off. Wow. It is rough down there. Jump ball. Wow. I tell you, sitting down there at midcourt, Jim, of course, that's where you normally are.
Right.
On the coach's bench. There's such a different perspective of the game.
You can feel the clash of bodies down there. Here as the shot goes up, everybody going for it. Hansen keeps it alive. It's like a block, but the ball is loose. Everybody diving for it. Finally, we get the held ball. And the officials were right. The ball was never tied up between two players. Everyone who was playing the basketball.
Palmer for Barnum. Elbers for Luverne. They'll jump. Luverne ball. Vink came off with it.
Luverne has changed their attack. They put Vink up high now to try to screen the top man. And he'll dribble off and shoot behind the top man right here. They got a double post. Vink high and Hansen low.
Barnum just absolutely tenacious on defense. They look like Luverne would have a chance down under, and they just closed the gap. Hands were flying down there, slapping at the ball. Luverne did not cash in. 40-32, Barnum with the lead, a minute 10 remaining. Third quarter. Peterson, rebound.
Nice rebound.
That was Lind on the tip-in attempt. Out of bounds. Barnum gets it back.
Yeah, hit somebody's leg in the scramble and went shooting out of bounds.
Oh, look at this. Oh.
Yeah.
That's where you'd like to disappear if you possibly could disappear at that moment.
He tried to put the brakes on. The ball is handed to throw, and here he comes. Vink playing for the interception, just doesn't get there, and he buries him. Vink's not made any claims to being a ballet dancer. He's a basketball
That's
player.
That's right. Left-hander pops it up. No good. That was Robbie Peterson and Luverne with the ball. We have 57 seconds remaining. Third quarter. 8-point lead for Barnum. Luverne moving it around. Siebenhaler.
Eight's the tough number for Luverne. They haven't been able to get it under eight. They were eight at half. They've been staying at eight. If they get it down to six or four, we'll have a new ball game.
Turnaround shot was short. That was Hansen. Didn't look like him. They've really put pretty much of a cap on him. There's the next shot roll.
There he got it.
He has 14 points. But he had 30 yesterday.
They've got it down to six. Now, Barnum is really keyed on him. They're sagging in, double and triple teaming him. They're keeping the ball away from Hansen.
Robbie Peterson back out on top.
Last shot right here.
Peterson, that left-hander, flicks that wrist. Luverne racing. Almost lost it. And, whoa. Pretty good shot at it there. And that's the end of the third quarter with the score of Barnum 40 and Luverne 34. So I had better put in parentheses there of
right.
Regulation time.
Right. Well, Barnum led 16-11 at the end of the first quarter. They increased it to an 8-point lead, 30-22 at the half. Now they've got the 6-point lead, 40-34, starting the final 8 minutes.
Well, I'll tell you, it's great having the coach's perspective here as being part of our telecast. We know the defenses, but Jim knows why and wherefore and changes. And, you know, it's obvious that you live, eat, and breathe. This is your life, that and your family.
Well, I get to see the halftime shows. I never see those before. We're always in the locker room. Had to travel, so Barnum gets the ball back.
We've just opened up the fourth quarter. Barnum leading 40-34. The Class A Championship, State of Minnesota, on the line. Peterson had a notion. Head fake. Shot Myrie. And he'll be called for traveling.
The ball goes back to Barnum. That was Vink.
Tom and Jim, I just got handed an interesting note from Larry Larson here. Only one other year in the 13-year history of Class AA and Class A competition has both class champions finished the season undefeated. Now, if Barnum wins, that will become a certainty in 83 because both teams in the Class AA championship tonight are undefeated, so one of them is bound to finish the season undefeated.
Barnum's giving it their best shot here right now. Here's a replay. You can see Juntman rises for the jump shot. He's challenged by two players. Right there to rebound it again, Juntman. He's going to get a two-shot foul.
That was the fourth foul on Vink, and Juntman comes up short. These are free throws he will remember the rest of his life.
That's right. He got it.
41-34, Barnum.
This is a good move by Barnum to come with full court pressure, not try to set on that lead. They're not going to nurse it. They're going to be the aggressive basketball team. Now they're back into their half-court defense.
Carroll back in. He's in foul trouble. Guns a 20-footer, and it's out of bounds. Barnum will go the other way. The Barnum Bombers leading the Luverne Cardinals.
Tom, I mentioned that there was only one other year when both teams were undefeated in both AA and A. I'm sure I got everybody's curiosity aroused. In 76, Bloomington Jefferson won it in the AA, and Marshall University in Class A, both teams were undefeated.
Right.
That was Johnson who hit on that last basket. Ed Prochowski was a coach at Marshall U. Back then, he's at the tournament.
Carroll in there with the Giants and doesn't get it, but it's put back in by Vink. He's right there to rebound it.
Vink's not afraid to get in there and muscle around even with four fouls. He played it wisely, though, went straight up and popped it in. Seven-point game, Barnum 43-36.
Laverne's thing in her basic defense, you might say, why don't they come out and play man-to-man? This is the defense they've played all year. They've got great faith in it. It's the defense that they know how to play, and they don't want to leave it too quickly.
Out on top, Carroll. That's Hoyland. Lob into Hanson.
There's the shot for Carroll.
Hanson has had a crowd around him all day long.
He does, and these other players have to take the nice follow-up by Vink. Missed it. Hanson. Oh.
He missed on the follow-up, and I tell you, the look on Vink's face when that shot didn't go, he wanted that so badly. Hanson was shooting it, but Vink was standing right by him.
Okay, here's Hanson on the inside. You can see Rob Peterson's there. Myrae is there. He's double-teamed. He bats it back out. Ball swings across. Lynn stays right with him. Juntman dropping back in front of him. They have him double-teamed, but he manages to get the rebound.
Free throw is up and good by Hanson. He has 15 points.
A quiet 15. He's just been working on those boards.
Next one. Got it? That's a good way to put it. Quiet 15. He's just been attracted a lot of defensive attention, but he's still a big factor. Time out on the floor with a score. Barnum 43, Laverne 38. Time here. Barnum's lead has been cut to 5.
Laverne can feel it right here. They know that they're only 2 possessions down now. They can get back in this ball game. They've got to do it at the defensive end, and basically they're going to try to keep Rob Peterson from penetrating to the basket.
Front court now to Palmer.
Ooh, the pass. Just didn't get there.
Vink had his sights on it. That shot no good. Fired up by Solheim, and we have a whistle and a foul. Solheim will go to the line. Or let's see, I'm sorry, that is Juntanen. Second foul on Hanson.
You see, Juntanen takes the shot. They play for the block. He follows his shot very alertly. Hanson's there with his hands up, but he hooks him as he goes up. Juntanen at the line for 2 big ones.
Got it. Darren Juntanen, 6'2". Senior, averages 11 a game. He had 8 points in the quarterfinals. They had 13 in yesterday's semifinals. Got them both. Good pressure free throw.
He said, what's everybody so excited about? I'll make these.
Right.
He walked up and made two.
45-38. Barnum. Luverne with the ball. High post. Down on the low side, and Cannigan is Hanson.
They relayed it from Vink to Hanson, high post to low post. He turned and eyed the basket and knocked it in. They're extending their defense now a little bit, looking for some traps. Here comes Peterson on the drive to Lynn.
And Lynn comes up a bit short on it.
He got pushed by Hanson as he got ready to take the shot. Here, again, it's the penetration of Peterson that makes the play. The drop pass to Lynn. Hanson tries to cover down. The thing that happened is Hanson had to come up and try to stop the drive of Peterson. And then when he drops it off, he's got to scramble to try to get back to his coverage and couldn't do it.
Todd Lynn, 6'4", junior at the line, averages 19 a game. But a good tournament. Not good. He had a great first quarter with 10. He didn't score in the second quarter. He now has a total of 12 points. 6-point lead, Barnum. 5:08 remaining, fourth quarter. 7-point lead, Barnum.
Every time Luverne challenges, Barnum's there to answer the challenge with a big play.
2-on-1, quickly got into the front court. Hanson, and comes up short. Saved by Barnum.
Good save by Juntanen. Went in, saved it back.
Lynn wisely stopped the dribble when he was cut off rather than charge into the defensive player. There's a foul from behind.
Yeah, called the travel.
Oh, called him travel. Well, looked like he got a little assistance.
He got a little help on that. He got bumped a little from behind. You can see it here. He takes the drive, pulls up. 32 Hoyland gives him a little bump from behind, and the official called it as a travel.
A little added inertia.
Justice is served. They get it right back.
Inbounding, Myrie. Number 35. Coming down the lane, firing it up short, Myrie, and now here's a battle underneath, and that is Lynn, and it's gonna hang up there, and it goes in. 49-40, Barnum. 4:15 remaining. It was tipped by Barnum, and the Luverne will inbound.
Coach Carroll's trying to get Luverne to slow down a little bit. There's still 4 minutes and 12 seconds to go. They don't have to get panicky and take quick shots.
Timeout on the floor with a score. Barnum 49, Luverne 40. Their lead has been dwindled all the way down to 5 points, but they just get to that certain point and they'll shove Luverne back, but Luverne keeps knocking on the door.
Tom, here's today's attendance, 8,835. The tournament total so far, 80,665.
Larry Larson, the publicity director for the State High School League, doing his usual fine job. You ask him for information, he gets it to you right away. There's a follow-up by Hanson. Big basket for Luverne.
Back down to 7. They're coming with some man-to-man defense right now. Leaving the zone, picking up man-to-man. Carroll fouls, trying to get the ball. That's his fifth.
That's going to hurt him.
Yeah, he's their leader.
There you see, Greg Carroll. He's a junior. He'll be back. See, how does he figure? He finishes with 10
you
points.
You can see the drive here. Carroll comes around from behind, tries to knock the ball loose, gets a piece of Rob Peterson's arm.
Darwin Siebenhaler replaces Greg Carroll.
Peterson's one of those players that puts out 100% but never breaks a sweat. He looks like he just started the ball game. And here it's 3:55 to go in the Class A championship.
50-42, Barnum by 8.
He's a very cool player. Look at him standing there, not even breaking a sweat.
He puts the wrist, but the shot was off to the left, and Luverne coming into the front court. Siebenhaler. Long set shot in and out, no good by Hoyland. Rebound is pulled out of there. Look at Peterson. He is all over. Barnum now setting it up.
They're going to play the clock a little bit here. They're still looking to score, but they want it to be a good shot. They've got the floor spread. Peterson and Myrie out top.
They want that clock to become the sixth man on the floor for them right now.
There's no one seated in the Barnum section. They're all up on their feet. They can smell it now.
Putting a little ice on the ball. They're nearing the three-minute mark, and a steal by Luverne. Three on one.
Peterson sprained his ankle on the play.
Traveling will be called.
You can see Peterson down in front of the Barnum bench. He turned his ankle when he fell, and he's limping off the floor now. I don't think he's going to be able to continue.
He is really hurt.
Yeah, he's definitely in pain. As he tried to get the ball back, his ankle collapsed on him. Here's the plays. He's driving down the double, and it just collapsed on him, you could see. It's what we call an inversion sprain when it turned under, and I'm sure that he's not going to be able to play. It's his right ankle.
Now, Jim, this really could put a complete change in Barnum's overall philosophy right now.
Peterson's been the player that's been doing everything for him in their hold game.
You can tell that he's in a lot of pain. Going to work on him.
There's a foul call very quickly.
Timeout here by Barnum. They're going to try to regroup with Peterson being out of there.
And now here is a message about drug abuse. Siebenhaler, his first. We have 2:58 remaining. Fourth quarter, and Barnum leading 50-42. But Barnum, they have lost their ace right now, Robbie Peterson, with that bad ankle.
It's been an eight-point lead most of the way. It was 8 points at half, and Barnum's managed to fight off Luverne and keep that eight-point lead, but there's still about 3 minutes to play, 2:58 to be exact, and there's still time to make up that deficit.
Peterson looks to be much better along the sidelines. He's jogging up and down now. Must have been just the initial pain of the turning of the ankle.
I think they'll keep him out unless it's a dire emergency here.
That's Myrie, Jim Myrie, Jr. They have a bunch of juniors here. Flat shot, and Luverne comes away with it. They are not done yet, the Cardinals.
There's only two team fouls on Barnum, so they've got two to give before Luverne goes to the one-on-one.
Hansen, they're going to have to get it to him, and he knows what to do with it. He has 22 points. He's really moving now.
There's the steal, but
foul.
He fouls from
Siebenhaler.
Behind.
Darwin Siebenhaler, his second foul.
It was a good attempt at the steal.
Well, they're going to send Peterson back into the lineup, and Solheim goes out.
He's trying to walk it out. You can see him working his right ankle as he stands at the foul line.
Jim Myrie again at the line. Comes up short. Siebenhaler pulls it out of there. They almost had him trapped. Luverne in the front court. Hansen had to help him out. Siebenhaler. Joel Elbers. They are really looking for Hansen now.
Great defensive play by Peterson. He came from the weak side and deflected the pass into Hansen. There's the steal at the other end.
Nice looking steal there by Vink. He's played a real good ball game for Luverne here. Jump shot. No good. Elbers.
Great follow by Vink.
Vink, 6'4". No little guy by any stretch. He has 8 points.
4-point game with 1:57, and they get the foul. They're going to send Rob Peterson to the free throw line for the 1-1.
That's one guy that you don't want to foul, I don't think.
No, you can see here he's limping noticeably. It is bothering him, but just his presence out there adds to the confidence of the Barnum team. They know that Rob Peterson's in the game.
Just like that, we have a ball game, a 4-point game.
Real big one if he doesn't make these.
He got it, perfect. He has 18 points.
He's taken over for Barnum. It was Lind in the first quarter. It's been Peterson from then on.
And rolls off. Vink with a big rebound for Luverne. 51-46, 5-point lead Barnum. A minute 50 remaining. And it is pulled out of there by Barnum.
Good
steal.
Gotta
get inside. Look at that. Wouldn't have counted.
No,
whistle
we had
before
the
shot.
First.
Foul called.
Yep. Luverne came down a little bit out of control. They know the time is not on their side. They got the turnover. Trying. You can see here, Hansen loses the ball. That's not Hansen, 32 Hoyland on the drive. It's taken, trying to get it back. He commits the foul.
Third foul on Mike Hoyland for Luverne. And at the line is Jim Myrie.
Myrie looks a little nervous standing up there.
Got
he
it.
He doesn't shoot it like he's nervous.
I bet he wouldn't want that one over
no.
again. Something happens when you hit that first one.
Yeah,
the
pressure's off a little bit now. It's back to a 6-point lead with 1:45.
Big free throw coming up here. Got them both. Pressure handled beautifully.
They're not going to back into this championship. They're going out there and earn it.
Long pass to Vink, and a good-looking steal there by Barnum, but Luverne with the ball right back.
Need this hoop.
Myrie got a little over-anxious. That was in and out. Vink had a hand on it, and now it is off to the races. That's Juntanen. Look at this. And Barnum, they are holding on.
Timeout, Barnum.
That's what to do when you're surrounded by white jerseys.
Luverne had some possessions, but they just couldn't get it in. Minute and 22, I'm sure Barnum now will spread the floor. They will take only the sure layup. They'll, other than that, they'll look to shoot the free throws. At the other end, still only two team fouls on Barnum. So Laverne's going to have to do it with field goals. They're not going to go to the free throw line.
In the opening moments of the ball game, it was Luverne, and then Barnum had things going their way for about midway through the first period on, and they have led from that time up until now, but Luverne has been eating into that lead. They got to within 4 points.
This is both sides of it. Luverne crowd trying to really spur their ball club on. Barnum just trying to hold on so they can take that trophy home with them.
53-46, Barnum, a minute 22 remaining, fourth quarter. The officials, by the way, once again, Phil Hall from Redwood Falls and Jim Plotnick from Apple Valley. Barnum inbounds. Juntanen triggers it. Lim
almost an over and back.
They want to stay away from that line. They want to keep away from the corner down by the baseline, like there.
They're doing a great job. They're in the half-court trap, and they've got the floor spread, just playing catch. This is a well-drilled Barnum ball club. Russ Radetzky sitting there like he's at the Guthrie, just watching the show.
Really? They must have worked on this.
Here, Coach Radetzky's getting up, talking to his ball club.
Well, the execution of that stall offense there, that very...
There's Coach Radetzky setting back, reaching for a drink of water, I think.
Looks a little nervous, but
right.
For the most part, calm. Free throw, Myrie is short. 54, they ate up a lot of time there with that. Down to 54 seconds. That may have been the difference. Rebound, Hansen. He hasn't given up.
Got to score and get a quick timeout here to get their press set up.
Long jump shot, no good. Elbers. That's one thing they don't need now is the clock ticking off seconds. Foul called on Barnum.
He had the turnaround jump shot. It just wouldn't go down for him. Drew the foul. Here he gets the ball inside. Turns, fakes. Reach-in foul by Myrie. They didn't want the foul right then, the Barnum staff.
Fourth foul on Myrie. And the first free throw
is good by Hoyland. He has 5 points.
Get within five here with the best with this free throw.
Nope. Can't do it. There's a foul on Luverne, and going to the line, I think it's going to be number 21, Dwayne Palmer. And we have Vink fouling out for Luverne.
Good show of sportsmanship on Barnum's part. They went on and congratulated Vink on a good effort. Right then, he didn't need any condolences.
That's right. Deep down, they were glad to see him get out of there.
Right.
I don't know if players appreciate that when they...
Depends on the players. I know as a coach, I don't encourage our players doing that.
Palmer will go to the free throw line and quick timeout. We have 39 seconds remaining in regulation. And Barnum leading by 6 points, 53-47. Following the game, we'll have an award ceremony. We'll bring it to you. Then we're going to take a break, and all of our crew will head up to the broadcast booth here and have some of Ann Ryder's fantastic homemade lasagna. And then we'll be back on the air at 7 o'clock tonight with the AA battle for third place. Should be a dandy. Chisago Lakes, their big guy Hasselquist against Wilmer, and big 7 feet tall Van Denide. And then the title game, Woodbury 23-0 against Coon Rapids 24-0. And we should break a AA attendance record since this tournament was split into A and AA, dating back some 13 years.
That's going to be an interesting final with Woodbury and Coon Rapids. Fans should try to get out and see that one, because it's going to be a great championship ball game.
Two different kinds of ball clubs there, I'll tell you.
Really are. Two contrasting styles, both very well drilled. Dell Schiffler's done a fine job with Woodbury, and John Gannon's done an excellent job with Coon Rapids.
Dwayne Palmer. Time running out on the Luverne Cardinals. Rebound. Luverne will get it. 37 seconds left. 6-point Barnum lead.
They've got to get it down. This is a good strategy by Barnum to go full court press, make him eat up some of the clock, getting it down there.
Putting some heat on him. Quick hand in there by Palmer. It goes out of bounds.
He tried to draw the foul, but Barnum would have none of it.
Shot out of the corner, Elbers, and the loose ball, Barnum, and time is all but over for Luverne. They've played a courageous ball game, but Barnum, they want that unbeaten season. They will lose possession. Nope, I guess it was touched by Luverne.
It was touched. Everybody stopped. They shouldn't have, because the ball had been touched.
And the ball
and
up in the air, and that's it. All over. The Bombers go unbeaten, and that's the end of the game with a score. Barnum 53, Luverne 47. 10 in the first quarter. And Juntanen had 9. And for Luverne, their leading scorers, we had Hansen with 22 and Vink with 8. Hoyland had 5, Carroll with 10. Now we go down to the floor.
Lieutenant of Schools of Hendricks, Donald Faulkner, school board member from Sandstone. They will be assisted by Mr. Murray Fring, the league's executive director. Class A consolation trophy was awarded to Brooklyn Center this morning. Class A third place trophy and bronze medal were awarded to Staples earlier this afternoon. Silver medals and the Class A second place trophy will be awarded to the Luverne High School. Silver medals will now be presented to each member of the team. Greg Carroll. Steve Waiter. Joel Elbers. Aaron. John Nikolai. Kevin Siebenhauer. Brad Aaron. Mike Hoyland. Tom Madison. Alan Fixie. Scott Smythe. Gordy Hansen. Tim Vink. Joel Pickett. And the student manager, Tim Van Engel Enhoven. Captains come forward and receive the trophy. The Minnesota State High School League is pleased to sponsor a sportsmanship trophy for the Class A basketball tournament. The schools of Minnesota have been actively involved in the promotion of good sportsmanship this past winter season. The evaluation committee has selected for the sportsmanship trophy for 1983, Clara City High School. Will the cheerleaders and captains come forward to receive the trophy for Clara City? Proceed with all right, we'll proceed with the awarding high school Class A basketball champion, Barnum High School. Each member of the squad receives a gold medal. Gold medals will now be presented. First, Lauren Peterson. Doug Juntanen. Jody Young. Wayne Palmer. Mark Solheim. Jack Peterson. Robbie Peterson. Pete Charbonneau. Rodney Sorella here. Rodney Sorella. And the student manager, Dave Schwab. Now will the captains of the Barnum team come forward to get your championship trophy. Congratulations to an outstanding Class A team. Ceremony is concluded.
always get a kick when athletes will hold up their finger, we're number one. But I tell you, when in Barnum's case, when you finish out a season 26-0, I think that you can hold that finger up and say, we really are number one.
And it wasn't a team that had peaked. They just got stronger and stronger as the tournament went along. And Luverne played good basketball today, but Barnum was not to be denied. They moved the ball well. They took good shots. They had everybody involved in the offense. And they're really deserving of the Class A championship.
They're dancing in the streets of Barnum, if anybody is there, in the neighboring town of Mattawa, as I understand it. The trail to the title. Well, I tell you, they came in here and they beat Brooklyn Center, a really fine Brooklyn Center team, 58-47. They beat Staples. Staples really got hot toward the end of the season. They beat Staples 56-53, and then they win this championship game very impressively by 6 points over an excellent Luverne Cardinals team. And I think we have some interviews down on the floor. Let's go down to Randy Shaver.
All right, thanks very much, Tom. With me, head coach Rush Radetzky. Congratulations, coach.
Unbelievable. I can't say enough about these kids. You know, we came into this tournament being underdogs, really not recognized with our undefeated record. These kids just kept plugging away and showed why they're winners. They just a tremendous group of kids, and I'm extremely proud of the whole community and their support. And it's just been super and a dream come true. I tell you, it was just unbelievable.
An unbeaten season, and you know you only lose one senior off this
one
season.
Senior. And these kids, I'm sure they want to get back. They've had a good time down here, and they conducted themselves like gentlemen all the way. And like I said, they came out when the pressure was on. They kept producing. They held their poise and did an excellent job on defense. It's been getting us through the whole season.
All right, Coach, congratulations. Let's bring in this one senior, Darren Jettman. Congratulations.
Thank you.
What a way to go out.
Yeah, it's really exciting. I can't believe we did it.
What were your thoughts in the final few seconds here? Could you believe this is all happening?
It still hasn't hit us yet, I don't think. It's really exciting.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
This is probably one of the men of the hour right here, Robbie Peterson. Congratulations, Robbie.
Very nice. Thank you.
You had a great tournament. You came in with a clutch, coming in with some clutch play after you turned your ankle, keeping the team under control. How's the ankle now, okay?
It's a little sore. It'll be sore tonight, but... It's
who cares, right?
Now. Who cares?
You're only a junior. You got a chance to come back. That's great.
Thanks. It's going to feel great coming back. And I don't know. I love this.
Congratulations. Todd Lynn, congratulations.
Thank you.
This has got to be one of your biggest thrills.
Definitely. This is great. Hope we can do it again next year.
You got to be pretty excited. A town of 382 people. Here you come to the state tournament, unbeaten. Congratulations.
Well, thank you. It's something. Everybody's behind us. We got the whole town is here. I hope somebody turned off the lights. We got everybody here.
Congratulations, Todd. Let's go back upstairs.
Well, I'll tell you, that's amazing. You're going to have... they lose only one player off of that starting lineup.
There will be a lot of pressure on them to repeat, and it's never that easy. Where do you go from here when you're number one? All you can be is number one again. But it's a solid group of young men. The smiles on their faces there as they receive their medals says it all. And on the other side, the disappointment of Luverne. You can't tell them right now that they had a great season. But tomorrow morning when they look back, they'll realize what they have accomplished. A team that lost six games during the year, end up playing for the state championship, ending up number two in the state. They've got every reason to be proud of their team in Luverne.
You know, we sent a crew to Boston and do a story on Kevin McHale, your former Gopher star, and he said yesterday, we brought the interview, we had it during the state tournament, he said when they lost to Jefferson in 1976, Kevin said he thought that was the end of the world. But 3 weeks later, he said it began to sink in. Gee whiz, we've just been through one of the greatest experiences of our lives.
That's right. And at the time, it's bitter disappointment. Both teams want to win that championship, but only one team can have it. And, Tom, that's why I really favor the class system. A team like Barnum, they're not able to go up against the Coon Rapids and shouldn't be expected to. But a town of that size, they are the state champs, and no one can deny it.
Hey, I got to ask you this. What do you think about that NCAA tournament, the way it's shaping up? What do you think it's going to head to?
Well, I like Houston. They've got some great athletes, but Louisville has a stable full of great athletes, as they proved today by beating a fine Kentucky team. So I think Louisville and Houston have the best talent. Whether they can overcome a Ralph Sampson and a Virginia remains to be seen, but it'll be a great week in Albuquerque.
While we have a moment or two, I've got to ask you about tonight. We have a couple of great ball games, starting with Chisago Lakes, their big guy Hazelquist, against Wilmer's real big guy, Van Denite.
I think Chisago Lakes played about as well as they could play yesterday and just couldn't get it done. They're going to give up a...